kind of stopped visualizing myself as a champion. Okay, it was just easier that way.
That's what keeps someone humble. It's exactly who you are. It's exactly who we raise.
If you fail and don't try again, that's failure. But if you fail and you strive and keep progressing, that's not failure. Those are just steps.
Welcome to Johnny Gargano's Wheel of Challengers! With one spin, someone will get the opportunity of a lifetime. Oh my God, I've never seen a wheel like this before. Totally unpredictable. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner is Leon Ruff! Wow!
When I say I'm just a kid from Detroit, or I'm just a boy from Detroit, like where I grew up from, it was rough, you know, no pun intended, but not a lot of people make it out. And by I mean make it out, I mean like make it out of poverty, make something of themselves, you know. But I always felt like there was more for me out here. And just thanks to my dad for moving us, and you know, I had more opportunities in Georgia, and I was able to find a school and train to wrestle, and that led me here. You know, not a lot of people get that opportunity, but I just hope, you know, watching this, they do. They take that opportunity to make something of themselves.
When we first started talking, I had a car, he did it. And he looks at me, he goes, Aja, I'm not gonna lie to you, I ain't got no car, I live at home, but I got a job, and I'm trying to be a wrestler. And like, what can you say to that? Yeah. Like, how can you bash him?
I feel like this is my moment. You know, this is my moment to make a name for myself, to prove something, and it's against the NXT North American Championship. You know, so I have to go all out. I feel like I wasn't supposed to be here anyway. So it is pressure, but it's to just show who I am. I don't want to like fail or anything. It's not that's my mindset. I don't feel like I fail. Even when I lose matches, I just feel like I learned something. So now after every single match that I've lost, I've always came back. You know, I've always came back and wrestled. I've always came back to the next show. So I feel like all of those has led me to this, and I feel more confident than, you know, afraid or anything.
That boy,
I'm hot, baby! I'm feeling hot!
Wow, how fortunate is it that the wheel has landed on Leon Ruff? That is a rank outsider. It could have been Ciampa, it could have been Priest.
By Gargano at this moment. Gargano looked for a super kick, got caught. Oh, crucifix pin, shoulders down.
Whoa! Oh, oh my God!
That's got to be the biggest upset in NXT history.
Leon Ruff is the North American champion.
I turned everything on my phone off.
Bye. your brother get you to get that to give that opportunity to do that? It ain't even your brother doesn't win a championship on
TV. You know how many great wrestlers held this though?
Okay, that's what I said.
Ricochet, Adam Cole, Johnny Gargano, Velveteen, like.
Come on, bridge up.
Okay.
Johnny's a two-time, the first two-time North American champion. The first triple crown champion. And he beat him.
It's so funny because I didn't know he was wrestling that night. And then my husband looked and he was like, is that Leon's name on the wheel? And I was like, no, that's not his name. And I went up to the TV and I was like, that is his name. Then when he turned around and he pinned him, I just lost it. I started screaming. Like, I could not believe it. Like, I felt like I won it. Just watching him and watching his face, I felt the same way he felt like. It was unbelievable. It was really unbelievable.
Oh, man, I feel so proud. We used to sit on the porch, like, make skits like this up, you know what I'm saying? And sometimes we come up with little ideals, and he would go do these shows in Alabama and other little spots, and I just seen the passion that he had in him. He would come home, and I'd be like, well, how much you got paid? And he'd be like, but they paid me $5, but I was good. Dad, I'm real good. I'd be like, well, son, hey, if you say you good, and hey, just built right here, bruising.
I'm not a parent, but I can only imagine just the fear of somebody you created. Man. Going into the world and trying to make something of themselves. And I know how hard my parents worked, so I just really wanted them to, like, have a chance to relax and just enjoy themselves and not worry about anything. So when they're here, you know, I'm just always making sure that they're just sitting down, relaxing, just, you know, so they don't have to work as hard as they did before.
We're so proud of you. We really are. And it's so crazy to let the world see what we've always seen, what we've always known. I think that's the part that's just priceless, because a lot of people be like, oh, I remember him. And he's always been just the same way, full of energy, full of love. And it just comes off that that's where he comes from, and he wants to share that. So I remember, like he was saying, somebody called me, they were like, I'm going back to school. Your son just got up and was like, I'm gonna do this, I'm going back to school. And I called him, I was like, my friend is going back to school. Just because she saw you wrestling and saw your interview, she was like, she's getting up, she's gonna go back to school, and she's gonna finish where she started. That's what keeps someone humble. Because that is you, that you always look out for other people, and that what makes a difference. That's what makes us proud. Not the lights, not the name, it's just that no matter when people say your name, it's exactly who you are, it's exactly who we raise. That makes a difference. It really does.
I mean, it feels real. It feels too real. You know, at a certain point, I kind of stopped visualizing myself as a champion. It was just easier that way. But now it just feels like something that I'm supposed to be, but man, it just doesn't feel like it's finally here. But it's cool though.
Wrong way.
My bad. No, it's all right. It ain't that bright. It ain't bright in my eyes, you know. Give me a kiss. Oh, you over there. My bad.
Next time I'll be in this building, I will be performing on TakeOver as the North American champion. Just, there's so much I want to say. There's just a bad stigma behind failure and behind failing. Like, if you fail and don't try again, that's failure. But if you fail and you want to get back up there, you want to keep striving and keep progressing, that's not failure. Those are just steps. You're just learning ways not to do it. And I really, man, talk about wanting to motivate people and actually try and change their mindsets of just life or just happiness, you know? Hope I touch somebody's heart. or just somebody's mindset or something.
I was on the indies, and I would watch like another indie show. I could always tell what the backstage was like. You know, because I was doing indies, it was another indie promotion, so I knew what the backstage, I knew how the people were, I knew what the scene was. But every time I watched a WWE event, I never knew what the backstage was. I never knew, you know, I would just watch it and be like, man, I really want to be up there because I just want to be a part of this. And then now I'm a part of it. It's pretty mind-blowing. I remember watching a dark match, and it was like Randy Orton, Ric Flair, Shawn Michaels in the match. And it was in Detroit. I remember that was like after the show went off or something like that. And I was like, man, they wrestling in the cage. On a Monday night, and I was like, man, I went to school today.
I used to look up just like a bunch of wrestling toys online, and I would see all the different ring sets and stuff.
I still see myself as that kid that's still chasing the dream. And it's not until I read the message request or the comments and somebody will tell me, you know, like their height and weight. Like, yeah, I'm exactly like you are. It's just so many little victories. And I'm just trying to make sure that I'm acknowledging them all. I don't know. It's so overwhelming.
No matter what happens tonight, I just... I'm just very appreciative of tonight. You know, I just want people to... Tonight is just the culmination of everything that I've been working for.
To tell people you never know what the next day holds for you. You never know what's gonna happen in the next hour, because the hour before I called and got told that I was getting signed, I wasn't signed. And I was waiting on that call. And it was an hour away. And it just took a year. But no matter how many days it took, every time a day passed, it was a day closer. People give up when it's so close, but you just can't.
My mom and dad couldn't watch tonight because they had to work. And that's all right, because no matter where they were going, that'll be on the network forever. And they can always see me do that. They can always see their little boy do that.
I'll be saying the same thing over and over again, but man, I'm happy. I'm proud of myself.